Well, sun, beach, the sea, so what's still missing? A few motorbikes, of course. So, welcome to Motorradreise TV, episode number 40. As you can see, we couldn't bear to stay in Germany for long. Now we're back in Spain. But first let me announce the program of this episode. During our short stay in Germany, we visited Touratech to take a look at the motorcycles of the United People of Adventure. After that, we'll return to Spain. The press test for the Suzuki SV650 has just taken place, and we were part of the entire process as a film team. Here it is, right behind us. I will tell you more about this in the show, and I will also speak about the new Ricoh Theta S 360-degree camera. To be honest, I don't want to get away from this warm and sunny beach, but now, for the time being, we have to return to cold Germany, to Touratech, as mentioned before. They are the people who equip motorcycles with everything that makes adventurers happy. So to speak, the lion's den for travel enduro freaks. Okay, off to Niedereschach, off to Touratech. And now let's take a look at the bikes for the United People of Adventure. Welcome to the motorcycle paradise Niedereschach, here at Touratech. As already mentioned on Facebook, we're here to take a look at a few really interesting motorcycles, the bikes that will travel to Madagascar with the United People of Adventure. Last year we have already reported on that project, maybe you remember that. People could send a video application and now the chosen finalists have been invited to Niedereschach. So it will be decided very soon who will actually be traveling to Madagascar, but it's already clear which bikes will go. On Facebook you could already post your comments on the bike and the equipment of your interest, and now we're going to check this out for you.
Welches Bike euch interessiert, welches Zubehör euch interessiert, und das gucken wir uns jetzt mal für euch an.
It's a motorcycle paradise in the truest sense of the words, and all the bikes you can see here are completely equipped by Touratech. But what else did you expect? Of course they've mounted everything they have. Okay, let's start with the KTM 1190 Adventure. Here it is, even in the R version. You can't see it now as here's still a bag in front of it. And André has written on Facebook that he has recently purchased an 1190 Adventure, so I guess he's interested in the equipment for this bike. So here are a few parts that I can show you. Of course, the 1190 Adventure has a lot of power, especially the R version. You can be really fast with this one, so a good windshield is absolutely essential for this bike. This high shield here is something I would definitely add to this motorbike. With such a bike, you will probably do some off-road riding also, and for that reason, a safe and solid stand is critical. Personally, I like this Pivot foot pegs and the brake lever extension, also because you can still use it with heavy boots or shoes on. This handlebar riser is also a comfortable thing when you're riding off-road. That way you can keep an upright position while standing and you don't have to lean that much forward. These are the things I would mount onto this motorbike in the first place, but of course you cannot travel without a pannier system. So they've attached one to each of the bikes here. Okay, this was a short overview of the 1190 Adventure R. Of course, there are many more bikes and I think we should now walk over right here, because there I can see the Super Tenere, a motorbike we didn't have in our show so far, but of course I've already ridden one. So let's take a look. Another bike for the Madagascar tour with the United People of Adventure is the 1200 Super Tenere, Yamaha's flagship product among the travel enduro bikes. I've ridden it a few times already and so far I'm not yet comfortable with it. That, however, doesn't mean that it's not a good motorcycle, it's just not the right bike for me. Maybe we'll get one for a test later this year. Anyway, when going off-road, a good protective gear is critical to protect the bike from damage in case of an accident. I think it's important to protect the bike from below with an engine protection plate. When riding off-road, you can easily tear your main fault on a stone or even tear off the oil filter or an engine part. Not so cool, really. In such a case, your journey might quickly be over. But a massive crash bar like this one should prevent a lot of damage. It reaches up to this point, which means that tank and fairing will still be protected in the case the bike falls on its side. I'm curious to see how this motorcycle will perform during the Madagascar journey. It's the bike for the rider from the African continent. So, let's see, what else do we have?
Schlägt ist für den Teilnehmer des afrikanischen Kontinents gedacht und ja, wir schauen einfach mal, was wir noch so haben.
So, okay, for the long way to Madagascar, I put a sandwich into the tank bag here. Enjoy it when you arrive down there. If I had a garage, I would get all of this bike. It's a dream, really. So many motorcycles and travel enduro bikes here at one place. Now I'm sitting on Suzuki's DL1000 V-Strom. We already introduced this bike in one of our shows. I'd almost say it's like the underdog among the travel enduro bike. It's a damn fine bike with an awesome engine, really a V-twin with a lot of torque. Riding this bike is definitely a lot of fun.
Und macht auf jeden Fall richtig Fun, die Karre zu fahren. Und
das ist das It's a bike for the participant from South America. And wait a moment, V-Strom in South America? Doesn't that ring a bell? Of course. Hello, Claudia. Hello, Mirko. I suppose you know this bike from inside out. For 1.5 years, you have been riding it across North and South America and showed us what this thing is capable of doing. This one is, of course, fully equipped, but one thing I would like to mention is the seat. If you know Claudia and Mirko, Mirko is a tall guy, Claudia has a normal size, so they had different seats on their bike. Claudia had the lower seat, Mirko the higher one. The V-Strom comes with a standard seat for riders with a body height of about 1.8 meters, which is also suitable for shorter people as well. You still reach the bottom with your feet, but with seats like this you always have the option to adjust them individually to your body height. You'll always feel safer on your bike when you reach the ground with your feet.
Mit solchen Sitzbänken hat man auf jeden Fall die Möglichkeit, sich die Motorräder noch mal ein bisschen individuell auf seine Körpergröße anzupassen. Das gibt natürlich ein viel sichereres Gefühl für so ein Motorrad, wenn man eben auch vernünftig auf den Boden kommt. Ja, hier bei der V-Strom 1000 auch wieder alles wirklich.
Also the V-Strom 1000 is fully equipped. A very cool bike, but now let's go over here to the next Japanese motorcycle, the Africa Twin.
Die dritte Japanerin im Bunde, die Honda Africa Twin.
Honda's Africa Twin is the third one from Japan here in this circle, and I've already introduced this bike and its TourTech accessories in our last episode. Here's one more little detail I just noticed. In Almeria we had the DCT version, but this one here is with a manual gearbox. It's more or less the same, but over here it looks a little different. The entire motor cover and the engine case and the DCT version is a little bit wider, and because of that the engine crash bar is wider as well. In this version here, the one with the manual gear, it's slimmer. It's sitting a little tighter at the motorbike and I like that much better. But how to improve something that's already perfect? And there's one component on this bike I find really interesting, and that's TourTech's suspension. In Almeria I already had the chance to try it and I liked it a lot, but I would like to do some more testing, and I hope that a bike like this in this color will end up in my garage someday soon. I'm already really looking forward to it.
Der Fabian schreibt auf Facebook.
On Facebook, Fabian commented on the Ducati Multistrada Enduro. It's Volkswagen's access into the travel enduro scene. Well, I'd rather say it's a Q7 among the motorcycles, so it's a really huge SUV that we've got here. But what is this bike able to do and how can it be classified? Are there any alternatives and what about the accessories? Well, there are at any rate lots of accessories available, as you can see. This bike was entirely equipped by TuraTech. And how does it feel to ride this bike? I have no idea. Particularly, no one has ever ridden it so far, as it has not been officially introduced to the media. But I think Herbert has ridden it once or twice. Maybe he'd like to tell us a little bit more about it later. Okay, so how do we classify this bike? I'd rather think it's similar to the KTM 1290 Super Adventure. So it's more like a bike for the luxury sector. Those who want a very big, well-equipped, top-level travel enduro bike may purchase one of these.
Top-ausgestatteten, top-level Reise-Enduro Brecher haben will, der greift zu sowas. Ob sie wirklich so agieren.
Whether it's really as agile as the name Enduro suggests when it comes to off-road riding, we will find out in Madagascar. I'm really curious and I'm also curious to find out how it actually feels riding this bike. I hope we will soon get one for a test ride and then I could tell you a little bit more about it and also about our impressions of really riding it. For one thing is certain, we won't be allowed to ride any of those bikes today, as they will be shipped tomorrow to Africa, and so we cannot risk that anything happens to them. Folks here are already giving us suspicious looks when we move them back and forth and turn them around a little. They better don't fall or get damaged before they get packed for the participants of the United People of Adventure tomorrow. But this was not the last bike for the participants. One is still missing, it's right over there, and now we're going to have a look. It's a Triumph Tiger XCX.
Und die gucken wir uns jetzt mal an, die Triumph Tiger XCX.
One of the bikes many of you were interested in on Facebook was the Triumph Tiger XCX, and here it is. We already introduced it in our show last year, and there it did very, very well. So it's a bike I can truly recommend, and this one has now handlebar risers. That's been one of my points of criticism last year. Back then I wasn't very comfortable on long distances because it forced the rider into a slightly bent over position. So this is one Tour Attack accessory that I would definitely mount to this bike, and as far as luggage systems are concerned, the bike has been naked when we had it last year. Now you can see which luggage options are available. Let's start with this tank bag. Its shape has been especially designed to match the outline of the tank. And of course there's also a Touratech pannier system with solid aluminium panniers, and up here it can be extended with two additional bags. And at the rear, brand new Touratech waterproof. Yes, that's a new product line in cooperation with Ortlieb.
Waterproof, ja, eine neue Serie in der Zusammenarbeit mit Ortlieb. Ja, und damit
seid with all this you'll be very well equipped luggage-wise and you'll have more than enough space on your journeys. In our channel there's a video that shows you how to load your motorbike properly, and here's the link. There are lots of things to be considered and there's some helpful advice in this video too. Okay, these were the bikes for the participants, and in the case you're wondering now, where are all the BMWs? Let's go over here to the other side.
Natürlich werden die Teilnehmer da unten in Madagaskar.
Of course, the participants won't be on their own down there in Madagascar. They will be accompanied by Herbert Schwartz and his team, and they all have bikes as well. And wow, this is where the BMW comes in. Here we have the 1200 GS with a new Desierto fairing, but it's not only BMW, but Triumph too. The new Triumph Tiger Explorer, again one of these huge travel bikes. There's also a F800 GS Adventure and a R1200 GS Adventure as well. Then we have another F800 GS with a big tank. That's Touratech's 1000 km bike, which means you can ride 1000 km without a refueling stop. I wonder who's going to ride that one. And last but not least, here's the KTM 1290 Super Adventure.
Also, interessante bikes.
So there are many interesting bikes going down to Madagascar, and now let's talk to Herbert Schwartz to find out what happened in the last weeks in this project when it comes to choosing the finalists.
Wir sind jetzt mit dem
With our United People of Adventure project, we have now reached the point where we have invited 12 candidates from 6 continents, so 2 finalists from each continent, and during the last stages viewing 200 videos of participants from all over the world has been a lot of fun, but it's been a real challenge too. And I really have to say that from these 200 participants I would have loved to take all of them with us, but that would have been a too big team, and so we had to make decisions. We eliminated the candidates and then started eliminating all over again until there were only 2 applications left. Rejecting the others was one of the toughest things I've done for a while.
Wir haben es runtergebrochen und nochmal runtergebrochen, bis nur noch 2 übrig blieben. Und es war die härteste Entscheidung eigentlich seit langer Zeit, dann diesen anderen.
It's been great to see all the ideas the people came up with in these short videos and to see their enthusiasm for the project. And now we are looking forward to our weekend with the candidates, but after that we have to make the hardest decision, to pick one participant from each continent and sending the others back home without their ticket to Madagascar.
Von jedem Kontinent nur einen auszuwählen und die anderen, ja, ohne Flugticket nach Madagaskar wieder nach Hause zu schicken.
Take a bunch of Japanese with clipboards making notes all day, take a bunch of journalists, place them in front of a bunch of motorcycles, and there you go with a press presentation. In this case, the presentation of the new Suzuki SV650. And now, let's have a look.
Schaut mal rein. Tja, die Pressepräsentation von der Suzuki SV650.
Okay, the media presentation of the Suzuki SV650 here in Lloret de Mar in Spain. Lloret de Mar, I'm here for the very first time, to be honest, but I still remember this from my school years when my buddies choose this location as a cheap travel destination for drinking. But when you're here outside the season of the infamous Lloret parties, you will find nearly perfect conditions for motorbike riding. And now we joined Suzuki for the press test as a film team. A lot of work for us, so 3 days in advance we filmed a lot of footage already, so the journalists had some nice videos to watch. We also joined the journalists every day out there making riding videos and then producing them the very same day, so it's been really a lot of work waiting for us. But now we're done, the press test is over and Suzuki has left. We're the only ones who are still here and I've got myself a key. Because of that, we can ride across Spain untroubled with the new SV650.
Der Pressetest ist vorbei. Suzuki ist abgereist. Wir sind die einzigen, die noch da sind. Und ich habe mir noch einen Schlüsselstibitz. Und deswegen können wir jetzt hier mit der neuen SV650 ungestört durch Spanien. V-Twin Sport hat Suzuki auf die Fahnen geschrieben.
Suzuki has written V-Twin Sport all over the flags that you can see here everywhere. But in fact, Sport isn't the first thing you may think of when you see the new SV650. But its aggregate unit has been revised. So the V-Twin of the 650 has now 76.5 horsepower and 64 Newton meter torque. So much has happened here. Furthermore, it matches the new Euro 4 emission standard. So the developers really looked ahead here regarding future requirements. And the sportiness of this bike compared to the Gladius may result from the fact that it has lost 8 kilograms of weight, which really makes a difference. You sit a little tighter to the bike, it has a low seat, you will easily reach the bottom, and the seat is also a little bit slimmer too. In total, this bike is much more agile. For our preparations of the introductions to the media, we have also ridden the Gladius, and these two bikes are totally different, especially when you ride the coastal road here, where one curve follows the next, it becomes really obvious how agile this motorbike is. And I can assure that riding it here is really a lot of fun.
Fahren damit macht gerade hier richtig viel Spaß. Ja, wir haben uns in der letzten Woche mit vielen
We've discussed the SV650 with many people last week, among others with its developers from Japan, the test riders from Japan and Germany, and of course with the journalists from all over Europe. And the feedback was downright positive. Well, look at it as it's standing here. A relatively simple design, very straight lines, and I would say nothing or at least not much to omit. A nice round headlight at the front, very timeless, and without much effort, you can convert it nicely according to your individual needs, like a shorter rear or other indicator. Maybe another seat or a nice headlight fairing, and your bike will look quite different.
Kürzeres Heck, andere Blinker, andere Sitzbank vielleicht und eine schöne kleine Lampenmaske. Dann sieht die Maschine schon ganz anders aus.
The technical features, so compared to the Gladius, more than 60 parts have been revised in total, and the technical stuff, especially the electronics. In that regard, this bike here is not fully equipped. It comes with an ABS, but without riding modes and traction control. But this is not necessarily required on this bike with that power. We've already seen the cockpit, the LCD cockpit with many displays at the GSX S1000. There's everything you need, easy to read, and you can adjust the brightness. All in all, I would say this is not Suzuki's high-tech bike, but it comes with a few reasonable features, like the easy start assistant, which means you just have to give the starter button a short push. The starter will work until the engine has started, and you don't have to keep your finger pressed on the button for the time. That's a little nice detail. Also, the low RPM assist is really helpful, especially in urban traffic. You just have to push the clutch, put into the first gear, and while letting the clutch go, you don't even have to accelerate to set off. Especially in urban traffic, this is a really little nice feature. So, well, I could tell you a lot more about this bike, but riding is better than talking about it. And since you cannot join us, we're going to a ride for you and show you some really nice pictures.
Und weil ihr jetzt nicht mitfahren könnt, gehen wir mal eine Runde für euch fahren. Und davon gibt's jetzt ein paar schöne Bilder. Aber wo ist denn jetzt der Haken?
Naja, but where's the catch? Well, a hook is missing. A hook to attach my aluminum panniers or my hand protectors, handlebar heaters, a big fairing screen, engine crash bars, engine guard and so on. More or less all the stuff that Touratech mounts to their bikes when they set off to a big journey. Then again, I have to say that the SV650 is not a bike for long distance travel or around the world trips. For that reason, a soft luggage solution or a tank bag will have to do it here. And that would be enough for a holiday like here in Spain, for instance. This bike would be perfect for it.
Here in Spanien, das würde sich auf jeden Fall für die Maschine sehr gut anbieten. Naja, wie eben schon gesagt,
like I said, it's a motorcycle to have fun with. I also think that if you will purchase this bike as a beginner, you will still have a lot of fun with it later, because it's expandable, has room for improvement. Even the experienced editors from various sport bike magazines got off with a smile on their faces. So the bike has a lot of positive feedback from the journalists and also from us. And now let's continue with the new Ricoh Theta S 360 degree camera. I'm going to get it now. We'll attach it here and then we will ride the coastal road up and down again.
Theta S 360 Grad Kamera. Die hole ich gleich mal, dann schrauben wir sie hier drauf und dann fahren wir noch mal die Küstenstraße rauf und runter. Wir sind zurück von unserem.
Now we are back from our little trip along the coastal road. We had the Ricoh Theta S 360 degree camera with us, which enables a 360 degree view. You saw it before when I attached it to the motorbike, and of course we have immediately started building a mount to fix it on the handlebar or wherever. Okay, now let's take a closer look at this little camera.
Insgesamt die kleine Kamera gucken wir uns jetzt erstmal.
Well, here it is, relatively small and compact with the size of a cell phone, but of course it's not made for phone calls, but to make photos and videos. A short description, one lens in the front, one at the back, so the field of vision is entirely covered. The pictures taken by the two lenses are being stitched together afterwards. We've got three buttons here and one more here. So this one is to turn the camera on and off, this one is for Wi-Fi, and this one is to switch from photography to video mode, and this one is the record button. 8 GB internal memory, enough for a 65-minute video in full HD. However, I'm not quite convinced with the video and audio quality. It's no professional level, rather pixelated, and the microphone isn't very good either. The photo mode is much better, and another good feature is the integrated Wi-Fi module, which enables you to operate the camera with your smartphone or tablet if the Ricoh Theta S app is installed. All in all, a nice toy, not more, as it doesn't match professional standards, so the price is about 400 euro. So the camera isn't exactly cheap, but gives you some nice new perspectives.
Das komplette Video von vorhin auf der Küstenstraße.
The video that we've made on the coastal road earlier today can be viewed in full length on our YouTube channel in 360 degrees. So use your mouse to drag the video, or if you watch it on your smartphone or tablet, just change your position. Just try it out yourself and watch the video. Here's the link. And now let's go back to the other beach.
An den anderen Strand.
Okay, this was episode number 40 of Motorradreise TV. We wish you all a good start into the new 2016 motorcycle season, which has just begun. I hope you're lucky with the weather. We'll stay in Spain for a little longer, so you'll see a lot more from here than in the next show. And if you have enjoyed the video, please give us a thumb up and don't forget to subscribe our free YouTube channel. And of course, you will find all the info on us and our team and this show on Twitter, Instagram, Google+, and in our blog on www.motorradreise.tv. Okay, and in this sense, all the best and always a safe ride. Yours, Stefan.